So I'm unboxing something really big today. It's a 49-inch TV from Spectre, which is definitely an off-brand TV, but I found a pretty good deal on it, and it, actually the specs look pretty good, so we'll see if it actually is pretty good. By the way, I'm also a little bit sick right now, so I might sound pretty poor, but let's get into this unboxing. And by the way, in the future, I really want to review this because it's an off-brand TV, but it has 4K at 60 hertz. So let's check it out. See, I got this TV from Tiger Direct. They definitely put a lot of stuff on here. So it might take me just a little bit to get all this stuff off of here before I pull the TV out. So as I cut open this box, which by the way, there's nothing really crazy on the box besides, I guess, this lady's face. So I'm not really going to show you guys the box too much, just what's in the box, I guess. I will say, you know, some of you guys might be going like, hey, Sergeant Pope, you got an off-brand TV. I've actually gotten other off-brand TVs in the past. I got a Psyche and also an Ocosmo. Both of those brands are really off-brands. And I had pretty good luck with them, to be honest. So I think I'll have pretty good luck this time, too. Here we got a first thing out of here, which, there we go, you guys can see that. Maybe just like a mount for the stand, probably, it looks like. It looks like there's quite a bit of foam in here. And also, I got this from Tiger Direct. And they had a lot of foam as well on top of the packaging for this. They actually like put it in a whole nother box, which is pretty cool. So I'd be pretty surprised if I have any damage, just considering how much packing foam there was. Here's the stand. It's kind of a weird stand on this TV, but we'll see how it looks whenever it's fully assembled and everything. Almost kind of looks like a Vizio stand. Like they have like this certain brand of TV or Vizio that kind of looks like this, but. Let's see, this is metal, so that's cool. It's not plastic, so I like that. Okay, yeah, so here's a remote right here. Let me move my camera so I can actually see this. No, don't do that. Okay. Okay, so here we go. It kind of looks like the Ocosmo remote I did for my unboxing of that TV. It's not really too crazy. I guess it gets the job done, of course. Source button, power button, all your general stuff. And looks okay, I guess. It's matte finish, so it doesn't... It's not going to show fingerprints, which is cool. And I think it's, I believe it's, fuck, I have no fingernails. Okay, there we go. I finally fucking got it. Whew, those are always tough. Yeah, it's AAA batteries. Comes with two of them, which is cool. Of course, AA's would always be better, but I guess that's just what they went with. Got a bunch of screws there, which is cool. Looks like they're really interesting screws, actually. But, I mean, it's probably not as interesting as a TV. Screwdriver, which is very nice that they give you that, especially on such a cheap TV. It's cool that they give you that. Here's an adapter, I guess, 3.5 millimeter to RCA, which is cool, I suppose, as well. Batteries I talked about before, which looks like they're off-brand batteries, but whatever. Thank you for your purchase, and they want to sell you some more stuff. And then finally, our last thing in here is... I'm guessing just a user guide. It literally doesn't say anything on this book, but I'm guessing it's a user guide, so cool. I don't know why they just didn't include that with the other stuff, though. Like, it came with another whole thing, and it had the remote in there and stuff. I don't know why they did... Whatever. Okay, now I got the TV on its front. Don't worry, the front of it's actually padded on the on this stuff that Spectre puts the stuff in. But let's look at the video outputs, because... That's like the first thing I always look at, and the audio outputs, I guess. Actually, I guess the video inputs, really. USB right here, headphones, I guess also 3.5 millimeter. Let's zoom in there. HDMI 1. Now, that is the interesting part about this TV. That's HDMI 2.0, which is actually fast enough to do 4K at 60 hertz, which is why it says that right there and why my camera is... being blurry, but that's pretty cool. That really sets this TV apart from other TVs. Like Psyche has some TVs that are like this, but they only do 30 hertz, and this does 60, which is cool. Also, audio or optical audio out with SPDIF and everything, which is awesome. Some of them don't have SPDIF, some of them just have like the coaxial optical out, but I like to have this one better because it's used more often, I think. Digital TV, I guess. I might find out in the review if that has a digital tuner in it. Hopefully it does. I believe it has to, but that's cool. Line out, which is that just another 3.5 millimeter out? I'm not really sure. I'll find that out for the review. Here's another HDMI. This is HDMI 1.4, I believe, and it's 1080p at 60 hertz. So I guess technically you could do 4K at 30 hertz, but obviously I don't think you really can do that. It's MHL as well, which I think you can do with like some certain devices and stuff like that, and I think maybe Roku as well. I think there's something about that. But let's move over here. Audio in for the VGA, I guess, right next to it. So 3.5 millimeter audio in, VGA. There we got component and RCA and everything. Let's see, the Y or the this yellow one, it's for component and for the yellow video of just regular composite RCA, which is cool. Both of the audio inputs and then components and then the yellow one too. So that's nice that they have really good labeling for all this stuff. Even though the stickers might be coming up a little bit, but whatever. And then a fourth or third HDMI. This one actually says 4K at 30 hertz. If you just want to do that for fun, so that's cool. And then you can do 1080p at 60 hertz as well, and that, which is nice. So I'm actually really kind of surprised they have the HDMIs spaced apart. There's HDMI there, HDMI there, and then HDMI there. That's a little bit weird, but I guess that's not the end of the world. Still pretty cool. And by the way, I like this system of video ports where they're like angled out instead of going back. Probably works a lot better for mounting the TV if you're planning on doing that, which I believe this has VESA mounts. Yeah, VESA mount right there. There's one hole, there's another hole, hole right there, and then a hole right there for VESA mounts. And it says it's UHD back there, which is cool, I guess. I think next what I might do, we've seen what's all in the box and everything, but next I'm gonna set up the TV, put it in my room, show you guys what it's like, maybe how thick it is once I put the stand on there and everything. I guess I'll also mention really quick, the power cable is connected to the TV. I guess you can actually maybe take this out though, but it's not one of those power cables that you can easily take off, which is kind of a negative. But anyways, let's show you guys what the TV looks like all set up. All right, so I got the TV set up now, playing some Office on my Amazon Fire TV. Look at, no, there's my legs, there's me. But yeah, it's, holy crap, is this TV so much bigger than that 32-inch I was here. Wow. I didn't mention the buttons along the side here. Volume, channel, what is that? Actually, what is that? I didn't even press that button. Oh, that's just set up. Oh, that's just a menu button. And then, yes. What does S stand for? Oh, source. Oh, that makes sense. Okay, and then a power button, of course. So that's cool. You get plenty of that stuff. Tells you what the input is and everything. So I'm just doing 1080p right now. I think the only thing I have that's 4K, that's 60 hertz, it's probably my PC. I'm pretty sure my Amazon Fire TV probably won't do that. Guarantee my Xbox 360 or my PS3 probably won't either. And probably not PS4. Anyways, but PC can. It was pretty easy to set up my soundbar, by the way. You just go through the menus and it's pretty fucking simple, which is nice. It's a pretty thin TV, as you can see. It's not super crazy thin, but it's, you know, definitely pretty thin. I will say the base is very large. Kind of covers up my whole table, and I had to put my soundbar kind of on top of the base, which I'm not crazy about. Maybe I'll look at that in the future and see if I can make that better, but yeah, there's a light for the power and everything. It's red when it's off, of course. It's just glossy around there. One thing I did notice, oh, by the way, the screen is glossy. You can probably notice that by, like, you can see my window right there. One thing I did notice, you know, off-brand TVs are never really perfect. I can feel if I push on the panel, it goes in a little bit, so it's not, like, super in there. Yes, it is what it is. And I haven't checked out the backlight bleed yet, but I'm guessing it's probably pretty bad. But the signal, I mean, 1080p looks pretty good on this. I mean, I guess as good as you'd expect it to be on like an off-brand TV. But I'll leave it at that. Thank you guys for checking out this unboxing. This TV is pretty freaking sweet. It was easy to hook up all my wires and everything, and pretty freaking awesome, to be honest. So thank you guys for checking this out, and if you have any questions about this TV, leave them in the comment section, or just wait until my review comes out, and hopefully soon. So see you guys later. Have a great motherfucking day.